Hi everybody, it's Amy and welcome back to another tutorial. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be talking about drawing short fur, so I really hope that you enjoy this tutorial. So a lot of people find short fur really hard to draw, and I've actually struggled a lot in the past with drawing short fur, so hopefully this tutorial will help to break things down a little bit and give you some helpful tips on drawing short fur. So for this drawing, I'm actually drawing an English bulldog, and I chose this dog because they have incredibly short fur, and you have to really pay attention to detail with short-furred animals, because it's not always easy to establish fur clumps or fur marks, and that's the first thing I noticed when I was drawing this dog. The fur was so short that it looked really subtle and soft, and it was a little bit difficult to really identify the finer details in the fur. So in a minute I'll be working on the fur around the eyes, and I'll talk a little bit about how I'm creating the detailing of the fur, what I'm looking for, how I'm picking my colours, and so on. And for this tutorial I am using primarily the Prismacolor pencils, which are a wax based pencil. I'm using these pencils firstly because I'm trying to preserve some of my more expensive pencils, but also because I wanted to show you that you can still get really great results by using cheaper pencils as well. But going back to the drawing now, and what I'm starting to do is start by drawing the fur around the eyes. And my initial method for drawing fur is to try and break down the fur into clumps or sections. And I like to lightly define these sections with the black pencil or a darker pencil. For this drawing, I'm breaking those sections down with the black pencil. And to determine my sections, I'm looking constantly at my reference photo and looking for things like the shapes or patterns that the fur is making, where the fur is positioned. So for example, what direction is it going in, what type of fur it is, and also the length of the fur, which will determine my pencil strokes. Once I've used the black pencil to define some of those sections, I like to build up on some layers of colour, and I'm fairly good now at picking out colours for drawings just by what I see in the reference photo, but if you struggle with picking the right colours for a drawing, I've got a video entitled How to Use Reference Photo, which should give you insight into how to break down reference photo and pick the right colours for a drawing. But when I am drawing an animal, I will always make sure I have some very light colours that will act as an undertone of colours, some mid-tones to build up on those undertones and base colours, and some darker tones as well to add value, contrast, and tie everything in together. So for that section of fur above the dog's eye, I started off by defining the fur strands with the black pencil, added in some light tones around the fur strands, and then gradually built up those layers by adding in some darker colours to add more saturation of colour to the paper. I've also added in some lighter fur marks by using some of the lighter colours, such as the cream and grey tones. So moving on to the dog's ear now, and as the fur is so short and subtle on the ear of the dog, it looks almost like human skin does, so very soft and flatter than you would normally see on an animal. So for the ear, I'm focusing more on shading some colour in rather than creating pencil strokes to give the illusion of fur marks or fur strands. And I'm starting off by applying some light tones using the side of my pencil, and then gradually adding in some darker tones to reflect the darker and lighter parts of the dog's ears, and to add depth and dimension to the drawing. So you can see how just building up on those layers adds a lot more saturation and colour down. You have the lighter tones in the centre part of the dog's ear, and then darker tones and colours on the outer edge of the dog's ear. I don't want the ears to look completely flat though, and when I look at my reference photo, I can see really tiny sections of fur. So that is why I'm starting to stroke that pencil and creating some subtle pencil strokes on the ear to highlight the fur there. And then what I am doing is adding even more contrast, colour and tone to the ear by going in with even more darker colours in this area. And one of the colours I am using for this section of the ear is the Tuscan Red from the Prismacolor set. Another tip I'd quickly like to make for drawing short fur is to really make sure that you are blending your colours really well in together, so creating a seamless transition from one area to the next, and to allow colours to blend well together, it really is best to blend colours together with the side of your pencil. So you can see here how for the ear of the dog, all of the colours blend really well together, and there is a soft transition between the lightest and darkest areas. You want it to have a natural look when drawing short fur. So if you aren't someone that particularly likes adding in lots of layers of pencil and want to save some time of slowly adding in all of this detail, then you could use a solvent to blend those colours out and then just go in with some coloured pencils afterwards. So skipping forward now, and as you can see, I did quite a bit of this drawing off camera, but now I wanted to talk a little bit about how I'm drawing the chin and the undermouth of the dog. And I thought it would be best to talk about this area because it's a lot in the shadow. So shadows can be incredibly deceiving, especially for short-furred animals, because it can be really hard to distinguish the correct colours in the dog's fur, how the fur is positioned or situated, and then it's also really hard to get in a lot of darker values in shadowed parts of an animal and try and make this look natural with the lighter parts of the animal. So for this part of the dog's face, I'm once again building up on those shadowed parts of the dog in layers. So firstly, I'm starting with a base layer of pencil, which is also known as the undertones. Then I'm building up on those colours by going in with some midtones. So for this dog, some creamy beige and light brown tones. And then finally, I'm adding in some darker tones in the corner of the dog's mouth, so some very reddy brown tones, dark browns, and even some of the black luminance pencil as well, just to darken everything up. I'm using very similar colours to what I've already used in the dog's face that I drew off camera, and I'm using similar tones to that part of the face so that it looks very natural. We don't want it to look like I did this drawing at different stages. Everything needs to look natural and soft with easy transitions between colours and areas of the dog. So it's all a process of starting with the lightest colours, building up to the darkest colours, and then just making sure that we get a good balance between applying lots of layers and then adding in finer details as well. So the layers will allow you to really concentrate on adding in lots of colour, tone, contrast, saturation and value down, and adding in detail will help you to highlight areas of fur, fur clumps, and make your animal look realistic. So looking at the portrait of the dog that I have done so far as a whole, hopefully you can see that this does look fairly realistic and how I've created the illusion of short fur, and it really is through how I'm using my pencils. So the fur is slightly longer around the eyes of the dog, so for that part of the dog I just made sure to use longer pencil strokes to draw that fur, and then for the shorter fur in the dog's mouth section I mainly focused on adding in a lot of shading in those areas. For the ears, it really was a case of just adding a lot of layers of pencil down to the paper, so going from the lightest to darkest colours and blending those colours together, and then just adding in a few pencil strokes in short strokes to indicate some short fur clumps in the dog's ears. So moving on to the very last section of the dog now, and this is focusing on the front part of the dog's body, and again, as this fur is very short, I'm just mainly creating and building up layers to create an illusion of shading, tone and fur clumps. So I started off by adding in a very light base layer of some creamy and light yellow tones, then started adding in some short pencil strokes of some reddish brown tones and light brown tones, and then adding in some very light warm grey pencil strokes to give the definition of fur strokes, and some darker brown tones as well to add in some darker value and fur strokes. And the darker pencil really adds in some depth to the dog too. It helps to determine those darker areas, so it gives the illusion of the dog being in shadow or perhaps facing away from the sun. And it's important to have all of these different tones in a drawing so that the dog looks like it's in a natural habitat with its surroundings. So hopefully by seeing how I'm applying those pencil strokes in real-time snippets as well will really help you to understand and see my process. So really see what I am doing and how I'm doing that, because it can be quite difficult at times to really follow along with what I'm doing when it's sped up into a time-lapse version. I also just wanted to mention that the fur on the dog's body was actually a bit longer than the fur on some areas of the dog's face, and that's another thing you really should watch out for on short-furred animals. They tend to have really short fur that's hardly visible in some areas, and then longer fur in other areas, so just make sure that you do reflect what you see in your reference photo so that you get that drawing natural and realistic as possible. So I'm just finishing off the last part of the dog now, but just to recap on some helpful tips for drawing short fur quickly, look at the length and direction the fur is going in, make sure you pick the right colours for drawing when you're drawing fur, apply layers of base colours, mid-tones and darker tones, and really pay attention to detail, so keep referring to your reference photo to help you. So I really hope you found this tutorial useful, and as always, please leave a comment below if you have any suggestions for drawing short fur or would like to ask me a question about drawing short fur. Thank you so much for watching today's video. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so that you never miss an update from me. I upload art-related videos 3 times a week, and I have a list of all of the materials, products, and equipment that I use in the description box down below. But anyway, I look forward to seeing you all soon. Bye everyone!